Concussion. The film opens with a footage of football player Mike Webster, David Morse, showing him in action during games, as well as the man speaking in a conference. In the present time, Mike is homeless and living in his car, suffering from dementia. Nigerian pathologist Dr. Bennett Amalu, Will Smith, is giving a testimony in court over a murder case. Based on his research, he determines that the blood on the defendant's hands was not that of the victim's because the defendant is a hemophiliac and could not risk something for possibility of injury or death. Bennett works at the coroner's office, where he has an odd habit of speaking to the deceased so that he can get an idea as to what it is that killed them. He is friends at work with Gracie, Sarah Lindsay, but is antagonized by Danny, Mike O'Malley. Bennett also tends to throw away knives after being used once. He is called into the office of his boss, Dr. Cyril Wecht, Albert Brooks, over this. Bennett asks Cyril if he would like it if Bennett cut his mother open with the same knife he used on a serial killer. Cyril says yes, and that he would personally ask him to do so. Bennett is asked to provide care for a young immigrant woman named Prima Mutiso, Gugumbatha Raw. He takes her to his home and offers her some money, which she appears to find offensive. Bennett explains to her that it's okay to need money and that it doesn't make her weak, but in America, sometimes it is necessary to fake it in order to get ahead. Webster visits Dr. Julian Bales, Alec Baldwin, over his condition. He appears to be getting worse. Webster is visited at his car by fellow football player Justin Strelchuk, Matthew Willig, who is also suffering from a similar condition. Webster complains that he doesn't want to go to sleep, so he is seeing tasing himself to stay awake. He is later found dead. Webster's death shocks the city. His body is brought in for Bennett to examine. He observes that Webster pulled out his teeth and superglued them back together. Bennett takes a look at Webster's brain and discovers severe head trauma that led to his mental deterioration. He brings this to Cyril's attention. Bennett furthers his research by studying football videos and noticing the amount of time someone like Webster took serious blows to the head. Bennett and Prima spend the night out and quickly fall in love. Bennett later proposes to her, and they are married, and later are expecting their first child. Strelchuk is seen ready to attack his wife and children, claiming that the voices in his head are telling him to kill them. His wife screams at him to get out, and he drives away. He turns up dead, and another football player, Terry Long, is reported to have died from drinking antifreeze. Bennett examines them as well, and concludes that the men suffered from CTE, chronic traumatic encephalopathy. He presents his research to Dr. Stephen Dekoski, Eddie Marson, and Dr. Ron Hamilton, Stephen Moyer, who reluctantly agree with him. After word of this gets out, it is believed that Bennett is trying to shame football, earning him a number of enemies. He is told to retract his statements, saying that he made it all up to harm the NFL's reputation. He does, however, receive support from Julian, who distances himself from the NFL's actions. Dave Duerson, Aduelak Anuoya Agbaje, is approached by fellow player Andre Waters, Richard T. Jones. Waters is suffering from a mental condition as well and begs Duerson to help him, but Duerson leaves him and walks away. Waters is later found dead from a self-inflicted gunshot wound to the head. Bennett and Julian meet with Dr. Joseph Maroon, Arliss Howard, over the matter. He chastises Bennett and thinks he is trying to destroy football, although Bennett continuously urges him to tell the truth that could prevent other football players from suffering similar fates to the recently departed. Roger Goodell, Luke Wilson, is made the new commissioner of the NFL. Bennett is called upon to speak at a summit for concussion. However, Julian later tells him that they don't want Bennett to speak, but rather for Julian to speak, since he was the NFL's neurological consultant, leading the two men to conflict. Furthermore, the FBI shows up to Bennett's job to indict Cyril on multiple charges for supporting Bennett's work, while also coming for Bennett. Bennett decides he must resign and look for work in another state. Prima is driving by herself when she feels that someone is following her. She makes a detour and loses the car, but she experiences a problem. She is taken to the hospital and joined by Bennett, where they are told that the doctors cannot find a heartbeat from the baby. After Bennett is forced to sell his home, he breaks down, feeling utterly defeated. 3 years later, Bennett and Prima are living in Lodi, California with their daughter. Bennett is called by Julian when Dave Duerson commits suicide and requested that his brain be examined. Bennett speaks before a group of people on his research while also simultaneously admiring the sport of football. Talks of CTE begin flowing through the country, sparking comparisons between tobacco companies and their denial of the links between their products and bad health. Bennett is redeemed, and he is offered a job in Washington. He later drives by a school during football practice and watches as two players run head-to-head into each other. The final text states that Bennett Amalu turned down the Washington job and remained in California with pre-mom Utiso and their two children. Multiple retired NFL players filed suits against the NFL for concealing information on concussed football players. The NFL settled on the condition that it would not have to disclose that it knew, and when, on the effects of concussion on football players. It was later determined that 28% of football players have or will suffer from CTE. All charges against Cyril Wecht were dropped. In February 2015, Bennett Amalu officially became a U.S. citizen.